So welcome all. Actually, I'll be talking a lot over the next few days, so I won't bother you more with, I think Professor Pathak has done an outstanding job of telling a lot of things about IIT Bombay. So before we wanted to have an introductory session. Naturally, the 250, even if I give 1 minute, it's 4 hours, so we cannot quite do, but over the duration of the workshop, I will try to get to know you better. But still, I thought we should spend maybe, given the time, half an hour to get to know each other a little bit. So what I wanted was, as teachers, share some tidbits. I think Professor Pathak has talked a lot about IITB system. Again, a select few of you, if you have something to tell about your engineering college, be it the students, be it the syllabus, or how things are, what can potentially be improved, I think that's probably a very important point, so that we understand how your systems work. That way, when we are developing this content, or when we are trying to realize the later flipped classroom or blended MOOCs model, it will help us address your needs better. So with that, I throw open the floor. So if anyone wants to share anything.
Hello, good morning, one and all. I'm Hari Sawan from Terana Engineering College, Nerul Navi, Mumbai. Especially here at Terana Engineering College, we have DZ class from Pearson. So whenever we used to take lecture, at the same time, that lecture can be recorded and can be played later on. So we have paid back up the lectures which we have conducted. At the same time, we have a server at maintenance place where we can upload the PPTs or simulations, and that can be used while conducting the lectures. Thank you.
So it's good to see that this technology usage for effective learning is kind of already taking off in other engineering colleges. In fact, there is a specific session which I'll be conducting sometime tomorrow about sharing my experiences with running a flipped classroom, the use of technology, the pros and cons of it.
Very good morning to one and all. My name is Praveen Raja from Sri Ramakrishna Institute of Technology, Coimbatore. In our institute, we loaded all the IIT videos in local server, so the students can view the videos without buffering. So if you are taking computer networks or programming videos, the students can easily share and views. And also, we are introducing the peer learning concept in our institute. So everybody is known, I think so. Many of the journals publishing the papers in peer learning. So just now we started the peer learning concept. I think it's use to the students, and also the IIT videos also very useful to the students. Thank you.
This is the NPTEL.
Yes, NPTEL videos.
Good morning. Myself, Dr. Mohammad Rafi, Professor, UBDT College of Engineering, Davangere, which is a constituent college of Vishwesha Technology University. Our VTU has launched a EduSAR program. In that EduSAR program, it is just like same what madam has, already introduced the system. So in the same way, our students are accessing for different modules, like for example, separate module for networking, separate module for distributed system, like that. So what I request is, same this what madam has introduced this system, same videos of IITs, if they introduce for our EduSAR, it may be more useful for our students. Thank you very much.
Hello, good morning to all. I am Sanjay Vidhani from KJ Somaiah Institute, Vidyavihar, Mumbai. Actually, we are not recording the all lectures, but the faculty who is expert in some particular topic, and those topics we are recording and sharing it with the students. Thank you.
Just a note. So I would also like to hear from others who are experimenting with some of these, what the student reaction has been to some of the experiments that you are conducting in this fashion. Are they happy with it, or has it increased learning in some fashion, or is there some quantification of the same? We'll get to that. Go ahead.
Good morning, ma'am. I am Srijita Asnath. I am from Savita Engineering College, Chennai. We are affiliated to Anna University. As sir said, already we are having the EduSAT program. So it is professors from Anna University, they take classes. Those subjects which are very tough for the students, we have such online classes. Apart from that, NPTEL and for in our college, we are having smart boards where we can use it as ordinary board, or we can download videos and PPTs and all that. So that the students are very happy with that kind of approach. And next, we are, other than syllabus, we are exploring areas like MEMS, robotics. So we do lot of workshop in that. The students stay back and they work in these areas. It is actually apart from the syllabus. So we find that the students, they show more interest in all these newly developing areas. Thereby we are doing this kind of. Thank you for the opportunity.
Good morning, everybody. This is Ashok Bansali from OP Jindal Institute of Technology, Raigarh. We have seen all these kind of things, this NPTEL lectures, the recent lectures by Google, NPTEL and IIT Mumbai, the IUC lectures. But the platform Bodhi tree found to be very, very interesting and useful because it removes this monotony or monologue, and the students, they enter into some kind of interactivity during the lecture. So that interest level is maintained throughout the lecture. This is very important. Secondly, if we are also working on this, and collaboratively, if we can develop a program or a project wherein a student can have a kind of game playing, through game playing, if they can learn something, then that would be better. That will even like improve their interest level. And last thing that I'd like to say is that request to Dr. Pathak, that we should also start some kind of mentoring program for the Indian engineering colleges teachers, because we too need mentoring from your side. Thank you.
Yeah. My name is Girish from BMS College of Engineering. Like, we are collaborated with IIT Chennai, IIT Bombay, on all those things, even the open OCM universities. But biggest challenge faced by faculty as well as challenges, the assessment. The key at the end of the day is assessment is the key. Like, really, students are getting what you are teaching, all those things. So we tried new thing, as sir was telling, 70-30. 70% is from our teachers, 30% from the MOOC concepts. So few challenges we are facing is, like, students are interested, but if they study this, will they get the score? So how to address this?
Yeah, I mean, just a comment there is, this is a totally beginning thing. We don't really know how to work out the logistics of running it. I think as we start using the platform, selectively interacting with the teachers, I think over a few years, I think we will nail down the right approach. And from then on, I think it will take off rather big. So it's a learning. So there will be issues. There will, as you probably already saw, Bodhi tree itself is not perfect. There are scalability issues still. But as I said, we'll handle them slowly over time.
I am Joyce George from KME Engineering College. One server which stores the videos from Massachusetts Institute of Technology and also NPTEL. But in my experience, very few students are making use of this facility.
Why do you think? Do you know any reason why that is like that?
Because students are not interested.
So one thing which we felt, which is, I don't know whether it is true or not, is which is true across many students, the really motivated students, no matter what, they will put in the effort to learn. Like, you don't really have to spoon feed them or do many of these things to get them to learn. They somehow figure out a method. It's, again, the weaker students also, I mean, if they're totally not interested, I mean, it's like taking a horse to water, you can't really make them drink. So those are also kind of, we can do our best and think we should do as well. But there is this good chunk of this average students who, I mean, if one has to really motivate them. So what often happens is, they, if it's part of the syllabus, so they may, I mean, the problem which I feel is what is covered in MIT or what is covered as part of this may not match the syllabus of your engineering college. I mean, there should be an incentive for them to watch it, because they're spending all this time, and then in the exam, those concepts probably are not covered. And you will only spend if you have the genuine interest to learn. Otherwise, they might as well spend time on something which comes as part of the syllabus. But that said, it is still a problem because these are the very people who, again, when they go to industry, they have to be trained all over again because they have not paid attention during their engineering college. So we do need to tackle it, but we should tackle it in a fashion where the students are still motivated to learn by working out some of these issues in terms of syllabus or somehow motivate them through some other means. So that's something which we need to figure out as we go forward.
Ma'am, I would like to add to what you are saying. I'm from Nirma University, myself Pooja Shah. In our university, we have introduced something known as audit courses, and wherein we offer them a course which is completely online. The material is completely online, and at the end of the semester, they are supposed to appear for an exam. So, along with the syllabus and the course structure which is there for a particular semester, a new subject which probably may not be of their branch, it may just be of their interest, they can appear for it and get a certificate for that. So that is very well received. And one another technique which we have introduced 1 year back, which was blogging. So we have started blogs for all the subjects and Facebook pages also. And students are very well receiving all these things, where we put up various online course related details and the certification related details. So it is very well received. And we blend those questions and quizzes in our class test and so on. So it was very well received.
Sorry for butting in, but it's a very interesting conversation that is going on. That's why I stayed back a little while, though I had to go back and attend a meeting. I'm thrilled to see that the use of technology in different forms is happening. And the key question that was raised and answered recently, why a majority of the students are not motivated to look at the best lectures available, best videos available. And as Kameswari said, as probably all of you are aware, unless there is an incentive for me, and if I'm a student, let us not beat around the bush, the maximum incentive will be mine if the material that I study is going to reflect in the examinations that I have to appear for. If it is not relevant for examination marks, because at the end of the day, my marks in my university degree is what is going to get me a job, not the best amount of knowledge. So that remains the cornerstone, and that is the reason why we have said, for example, in the blended MOOCs, that syllabus itself should become a syllabus. So I think you should continue this discussion. A lot of important points are coming up.
My name is Arul Murugan from Banariaman Institute of Technology from Tamil Nadu. Our teaching methodology is entirely different. We used to follow CLM method, Creative Learning Methodology. Here we'll be taking only 30 minutes of lecturings. Rest of the class fully interaction sections, showing videos and quiz and 2 mark questions and 16 mark questions we'll be discussing. And we'll be making interaction with the students, and students may can ask doubt for around 10 to 20 minutes. Totally, the total hour of our teaching methodology is 1 hour 15 minutes. So it will be more interactive with the normal classes.
So how are you so one of the things is, like, if you make it in this particular fashion, the amount of content you can cover significantly reduces. So do they do something offline, or everything, if it is face to face and the way you have told, it becomes very difficult to finish the syllabus, because the discussions, you cover just one small concept, the discussions will be for half an hour. So how do you manage with the syllabus?
Syllabus will be totally 45 hours.
45 hours.
Good morning. I'm Dr. Mahesh Yadav from Mata Rajgaur Institute of Engineering and Technology, Rewari, Haryana. I came here back in 2013 to attend the workshop DBMS. And by the inspiration of Dr. Sudarshan, I started something in my institute that to support the students for their GATE examinations, I discussed in my department with my fellows to prepare only for two subjects, the PDF and the PPTs file. One was for the DBMS and another was for data structure. We prepared these two courses. I was one of them and one was by my colleague. We put it on our internet. Students, even as well as the faculty members, they can go through these and can, if they have something to discuss, because we made it around 100 pages in PDF and around 100 PPTs. So this kind of activity is supporting very much to our students to prepare for their GATE examination for particularly these courses. We are trying to add more one. This is computer networks.
Okay.
And as I gone through your videos, that is quite very good, very much interactive. We are planning that anyhow we will try to make those two subjects as well as the computer network to prepare in such fashion so that it will be more effective and the more interactive for the students.
So Abid will discuss about how to take some of in the final, on the final day. We will, so again, this platform that was built is mainly for you. So when I have used it in IIT Bombay, but since we are there here, we can do face-to-face teaching, whatever. So IITB students don't need it as much as the outside engineering college teachers as well as students. So how to take this platform forward so that you can benefit is something we will discuss in length on one of these days.
Good morning, everyone. Myself, Rupam Sharma from Don Bosco College of Engineering and Technology. I want to just would like to say a little experience that that I had while teaching computer networks in the last year. While I was trying to teach some of the algorithms, I feel students are not interested. Then later I thought like how I can bring their interest. Then until I realized that in one of the class I started throwing them some challenge. Like for example, we had the Wi-Fi network. I simply told them, let me see if how many of you can break our Wi-Fi key. Because we had the Wi-Fi network at that time. And I gave them some time, 1 week time, and surprisingly, I noticed like many students, they started going through the like the backtrack, the Kali Linux systems, and they came up with solutions breaking our Wi-Fi key. In fact, I could see that the moment I started throwing challenge one by one, then I finally told them like, can you hack our own website that we have? Go for a SQL and so on. I observed that students are taking much more interest when I started throwing some challenge that actually were not a part of our frame syllabus. So that is a good experience that I had got during the last year. And I myself tried to frame the syllabus in such a way that it becomes an intermediate between the frame, the traditional syllabus that we have and some of the implementation that they can actually do to put their interest into this subject. Thank you.
Sure. I mean, I'll just like to add a point. So even the same thing is true even of IITB students. In other words, it's not that motivating them is one of the biggest problems we face. Again, if you throw a challenge, they rise up. In fact, they love many of the courses here. The undergrad courses have an associated lab and they all love the lab because labs are really tough. The idea of doing some of the lab exercises as part of this workshop is such that, you know, unless they actually see things in action, they can't quite relate to them. So any concept you're covering, if they are able to see it in action and then they go through the traces and they say, wonder, oh, this is how things are working in practice. Then there is motivation for them to go back, understand the concept better, because without understanding the concept, they cannot really understand what is it that they are seeing. So many of the, so this networking course, the way we conduct here is we cover a concept and more or less for every concept, there is an associated lab exercise associated with it. So that kind of keeps them motivated to pay attention to the theory as well. Lab, they're quite interested. And on top of it, like throwing an additional challenge, which kind of like the projects, sometimes we make them open-ended, whoever designs the best communication design, whatever. So they try to beat the other teams. And so there's a healthy mix of challenge that tends to keep them motivated.
I'm Dr. Rakesh Singhai. I have come from the Rajiv Gandhi Pradyogiki Vishwavidyalaya, RGPV Bhopal. It's a affiliating institute. And in our state, we are facing a lot of good faculty problem. So the RGPV had taken initiative with the Amrita University. We installed the AVU software and all, studio is there. And we are telecasting, broadcasting some of the lectures. And this would be similar to just like a Zyntec classroom. We had a timetable over there. And the whole syllabus is being covered by a single teacher. It's just like a classroom. And that we would be calling it as the e-lecture and that would be delivered. Unfortunately, the things are not going well, so well, which should have been. I don't know what is the problem. But the things has been started in our state. That's we want to tell you.
Good morning, Tal. I am Mohan from Srinivas Institute of Technology, Mangalore, Karnataka. Actually, I am taking security class to a semester. My plan is every day I'm going to explain about what is today's update on security. That is one innovative things I am doing. And after completions of that 1 hour, at the end I will give some question related to placement. What question they may ask in placement, and some of the important question for final exam. What question may come and how to write the exam, how to write the solution for that. All these things I am providing for them. And student felt it is very good. And in 1 week, okay, I will give one small tool, execute it and find out what is the result they are giving. And best example is, you already expected TCP dump is the best tool to identify about network. That is the one tool I am given, and Wireshark. And TCP dump, Wireshark, and brute suit is the one more tool we are having. And they found that it's very good, and we are getting some knowledge because of this tool, how it is used, and how the market people are using it. Yeah, there I got benefit. Students felt that, yes, it's good.
Yes, as I said, hands-on, I think, is the way to motivate, which is kind of universal.
I am Tejas from RK University, Rajkot. We are a state private university. Before 6 months, our evaluation pattern was 50% weightage of in-semester examinations and 50% on final examinations. But now we have changed the examination pattern. Instead of conventional question papers, now we have given freedom to faculty members that they should design the evaluation pattern for their own subject. If they want to incorporate research paper reading or continuous quizzes, it is up to them. So they are now they are finding teaching more interesting, and students are also finding more interest. So in programming subjects, instead of asking theory questions or conventional question papers, it is better if projects are given or programming assignments are given. Moreover, now we are moving towards activity-based learning. Instead of a monotonous 1 hour of lecture, at every 20 or 30 minutes, teacher will give some activity to the students so that they maintain their interest. Thank you.
I am Jitendra Singh Rathore from Oriental College of Technology, Bhopal. Three tasks that I have done with the student, and it's give a very good result. First, we have conducted a quiz in TechFest using Akas, and it gives a very good response from the student side. Secondly, in final year, I have to there is a new subject introduced by our RGPB, that is cloud computing. But in final year, what happened, students are more, their orientation towards campus. So they give little time. So what I have I have make a PPT and share on slide share, and just give the link to them. And what happened till end of the session, around 5,000 download and views are there. And there are lots of comments are also there. So it's a very good activity while sharing the information. In computer network, what I am seeing done in first lab, students are very good for listening in classroom. But while they are going to the lab, they are not interested in first lab. So as what I have do, I have make a telnet server, SSH secure cell on Ubuntu, and connected with the Wi-Fi. And I have allow all the students to connect with their Android phone. For that, I have suggest them, you have to just download what connect from the Android app store. And they have just start accessing the remote login. I just created them, and they enjoying a lot and understand how computer networking and other subjects are working. This is a very good activity, and thank you so much.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Dr. Vinish Sharma from Krishna Institute of Engineering Technology, Ghaziabad. It is affiliated from Uttar Pradesh Technical University. I just want to share my perception. I don't know how much you will be agree from my perception. My perception is the best teaching methodology, classroom, blackboard teaching technology. I think that we have experimented a lot of things. We have our own dedicated server having all the NPTEL lectures, but I am agree to my friend that none of the students were sincerely doing or accessing that server. So what we do, that we copy all the materials of video lectures, e-books, some good textbooks and reference books, PPTs, some good research papers, lab manuals,
in one DVD, and at the commencement of the academic semester, we just distribute that DVD to all the students. So we are having the variety of students. Some good students will go through the all the lesson plans, and if they are interested content beyond the syllabus, they directly click on the link and get the contents, very good contents from the DVD itself. So this is, I think that it is working well, and it may be appreciable. All the lab manuals, lecture notes, e-books, variety of good research papers, they all are available with the student in the DVD form. Thank you.
I mean, just to add, I agree that no one can beat a best teacher who is kind of using a blackboard and making the classes interactive. I think there is no solution to that. I mean, no alternative to that. But that said, I think in tomorrow's class, when tomorrow's lecture, well, I'll talk about flipped classroom. I will elaborate on, so when I have experimented, I was teaching the traditional way, using the blackboard and doing it. And then I also experimented with a flipped classroom, which is use of technology to do it. And I'll contrast my experiences in doing both. Both have pros and cons. This is not like a solution to all teacher troubles. So there are pros and cons, which I will cover tomorrow.
Hello, good morning ma'am, good morning to all. My name is Satyana Champadre from Silicon Institute of Technology, Bhuvaneswar. I just listened the interaction among the faculty members, but actually our institute is affiliated to Biju Patnaik University of Technology, which is in Odisha, and it's a private institute, so we don't have the control over the course curriculum. So course curriculum is fixed, and there is another problem that the question asked in the university exam. Even if we go for teaching beyond the syllabus, normally in the university pattern, the question is not asked. Most of the questions are like explained like that. So because of which the students are mostly not interested to go beyond the syllabus. So in our institute, what do you do? Normally that we plot a handout, and in the handout we mention that, okay, something is in the syllabus and something are beyond the syllabus. And we emphasize beyond the syllabus. And we found that that works fine. And beside that, the student, those who are opting for beyond the syllabus courses, then give the options, and we teach the students in a separate class. And we find that we started this in 2008, and in 2010 it clicked, and one of our students got All India Rank 1, and he is the student of here, Arindam Bhattacharya from M.Tech from IIT Bombay. And three of our students also doing the PhD in IIT Bombay in Department of Computer Science. And then we found that, okay, beyond the syllabus is good, but attracting more number of students to learn the beyond syllabus is difficult. Still, we are trying to do that. And we are putting the NPTEL video and MIT OpenCourseWare and other things in our server. And we find that most of the students, they are watching these things, and they are going for that quiz and et cetera, et cetera. They are seeing that. But still, day by day, we are facing that the number of students attracted to learn the beyond the syllabus is difficult.
No incentive for them.
And ma'am, one request is that your video is really excellent. I have seen that. As you are saying that, okay, if you can please allow us or something to do
see, that is what. So as I said earlier also, the content I have created is only for others to use it. I would very much like everyone to use the videos, but as is some copyright, I mean, I have to take permission of IIT Bombay, so we are kind of trying to figure out. So definitely, I mean, I'm pushing for the content to be available for all, so that you can use it, share it with your students, and use it to run your courses, in fact. So
good morning, ma'am. Myself, Varsha Nemade, working in NMMS University. In our college, we are using Blackboard Management System. That is one of the software. And every faculty, after their lecture, they have uploaded their PPTs or videos or NPTEL videos. And after that, the students, we will put the quizzes, online quizzes on that, and student will solve the questions online, or some of the practicals, ideas, they write the algorithms for that. So it is useful for the students. And after lectures, we can we tell the students, summarize the lecture. So it is the helpful for the students. Thank you.
Good morning, madam. I am from GRIT. My name is Dr. Padmalaya Naik. Actually, madam, that is, I have come for this workshop. I am having one lab also. I got the, that is the funding from IIT and UGC. So normally I am want to motivate more students, but what happens, we have obtained the outcome-based education system. In that OB system, one unit you have divided into number of lessons. In each lesson, we have put what is the objective and what is the outcome. And every time after each lesson, we map what is the objective, satisfying the outcome. So accordingly, that is, we are obtaining some simulators, like that is the NetSim simulator, NS2 and QualNet. And with that is, students are directly, there are some experiments they are doing, and some research problems also I'm giving they are doing. But problem with that, not much of the students are motivated. So just I have come to hear, that is, what exactly, in which way, whatever our objective and outcome, in which way that is we can do more lab sessions, and in which way that is you are motivating us to do the work. Thank you.
Yeah, we'll see whether our labs, you can go through our labs and see if these motivate them better, or a well-designed lab is also very important for them to stay motivated.
Good morning, ma'am. I'm Neha from KIIT College of Engineering, Gurgaon. What I personally do is that instead of giving the students whole syllabus at one time, I give them weekly. Every Saturday, I mail them the content which has to be covered next week, so that we can discuss it next week. But students, what their feedback is, that we feel supervised learning is much better than unsupervised learning, so that we can ask you the questions. From the videos, if we totally rely on videos, we don't get our queries answered.
Sure.
If you have with us, that we can have our queries answered. So
totally
that
agree.
Is the
yeah.
student's feedback from it. Thank you.
Yeah, I totally agree with that feedback. So one last question, and we will break. As I said, I'm around during the lab hours. Even otherwise, if you have something to convey, please feel free to meet me and convey whatever thoughts you have.
So very good morning to one and all. This is Srinivasu from Regency Institute of Technology, Annam, affiliated to Puducherry. Ma'am, actually, I mean, when I taught the different subjects like computer programming and the computer networks, the students are faced a little bit difficult. Maybe I'm not reached them completely. So because of that, the knowledge gained by the student is a little bit lesser. So I thought of that, how I can decrease this problem and how I can solve this one. Then I thought a basic idea that, so generally the persons who watch videos like a movie, they can remember long time. So here just I made a modification in that. I'm not directly providing any video. Whatever class I taught in a classroom, and just I'm giving an assignment them to play a role play. And within that role play, after completing the role play, I'm placing a quiz also. So because of this result, I got succeeded, and the pass percentage or the knowledge gained by the students also been increased from 70 to 90. So previously it may be a 70, then it is increased to 90. So that is what I introduced, a innovative method. Actually, it is not my own plan. So in the 2007, the Wipro Mission 10X, maybe some of them are aware. So they've been conducted some workshops for faculty only, to increase the teaching abilities. So in such a way that I learned and I implemented, in that case I succeeded very well. So the students are also loud, because when I'm giving simply a video to watch them, they are saying that, yes, we completed, but they didn't. So when I was doing in front of me, so they are at least participating and they are trying to catch. So whatever it is, the role play played by the student itself. Because it is making that almost a two types. One is already I've been engaged with the students, and the same topic been covered when I found leased hours, because it is not possible to take more and more. So in such leased hours, I assigned in a role play. So the students got very interested and they loved a lot. Thank you.
Okay, let's break for tea.